Jeff Benson, as usual. Welcome back. Of course, this is Topsal, one of the leading distributors of cake products, actually. Mm-hmm. And we are proud to be with them because our products get to the market through their shops. Perhaps, if I may say, the retail shop. So we have a vanilla cake, which we are going to make, Mercy. Yes. We want to change it into a mango and lime cake. So we make our name, the name of our cake, unique. So we are making a signature cake of mango and lime. But in the section of mango, we are using the real fruit as our fruit filling, which we have actually showcased previously,
yes,
that we've used the neutral glaze and the mango aroma to fortify the fruit so that we lengthen its lifespan within the cake. So since mango also has some sort of acidity, and to protect it from getting spoiled due to exposure to air or its induction into the cream, we have used the neutral glaze to fortify that mango. So this one, even if you put in a container and keep in your fridge with the glaze, it will stay in your fridge even for more than 2 weeks without a problem. So you can do enough, you can use a portion, keep the rest in the fridge, you use that, yes, it ends.
Yes.
So no issues. Now, lemon will be incorporated into the into this cake through a syrup.
Yes.
And now you can use normal lemon syrup, but now with us here, we have water, pure water, which we need to sweeten. We need to sweeten a bit with the sugar. So I'm trying to make a funnel to put the sugar into my tin. So just with a slight small opening in front, and then we place it there and put like 3 teaspoons of the sugar to avoid the spilling. So like 3 or 4 teaspoons to sweeten the water.
Mm-hmm.
And from there, now this one is fully used.
Do you need a particular ratio for water?
Not really, it depends on how sweet you want it. Depends on how sweet you want the water. Remember, the cake is also sweet.
Okay.
So it depends on how sweet you want it. So now that is normal sugar.
Mm-hmm.
And keep this aside. Then we have our lemon aroma, which is so natural in terms of taste and flavor and even smell. So like 2 drips, then we close our container and shake it. So now we mix the sugar and it's always advisable. We have used the sugar to make the syrup directly, but it is always advisable to boil your syrup. The sugar and the water, you boil together and let it cool. Now you can add the aromas on the table. So if you boil in a large quantity, you just keep your 5-liter jerrycan and take it in portions as you want to use your flavors at different times. That can take you even a week or 2 weeks or a month if you refrigerate. So
what happens if you use hot water? You add aroma to hot water?
Not really, no, there's no effect. But you cannot boil it together because this is already directly edible. Even if you add it while boiling, no problem. But if you want to make diverse flavors, then you need to boil the sugar syrup aside, which is plain, like the neutral glaze the way it is. Then you can portion according to how you want the flavors. That makes it more easier. So my syrup is ready. You can see it's green in color, like lemon.
Yes,
the taste also is lemon. The flavor, the smell is all lemon. And then we have our mango. Now our cake is here. We need to do 3 layers. So And now you have your mango. My mango, then I do a layer of this fruit filling of the mango and I give it in plenty. The glaze also makes the cream fail to absorb the mango juice into the cream. Now the glaze has sealed the mango from releasing the juice into the cake. You see, for example, where people do the passion cakes. Mm. So passion is light because it's like pulp. When you use it directly without the glaze, the cream absorbs the whole liquid and then you are left with the bagels on top. So you find that it's like it's dry, it's like there was no passion. But if you take that passion and put at least a tablespoon of the neutral glaze, then it will seal it from getting absorbed into the cream. So you'll have your cake with the topping very well and looking very fresh. Even on top of the cake, it will look very fresh and the cake will not absorb the juice from the passion pulp. Yeah, and that way you'll have your cake appearing very well. We'll do drips and cover the top with that. Like I said, you first get the portion you want. Make sure you close this to avoid cross contamination. Then you keep it aside. Yes.
And one package and deliver this cake maybe to Kisumu or Nakuru.
It is possible. Mm-hmm. Although even when on transit, mm-hmm. the people involved in transporting the cake also needs to be stable, because it depends on how rough the driver is, actually, or whoever is delivering the cake. But if you handle it well, it can get to Kisumu. It can get even to Mombasa.
Everything intact.
First of all, yeah, intact, very well. You as you can see, my cream doesn't wobble. Mm. Even if you shake it, doesn't wobble. So the cake is very stable. If you close it very well in a box and make sure that there is no an opening which might put anything that which may contaminate the cake, then you give it to a vehicle which doesn't have too much roughness in driving, then the cake will get there very safe. Yeah, even the cream will actually hold for those hours until it is fast, considering that it's non-dairy, so it will get there in good condition. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but if you are going long distances, it's advisable to transport these cakes during the night, because there is no much heat. Mm-hmm. Like if it's going to cost, you know the heat in Coast, you know the heat in Kisumu. Mm-hmm. So taking it there during the day, there's too much heat around. So that can also affect the cake. But if you transport it at night, I don't think you will see these problems. It will get there very safely. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we're using our 2D nozzle, and we would need to use the mango aroma, since we have the mango filling inside. But since I have this, that is just a concept. So we use the mango aroma on the cream, and then make sure it's soft and stable before you put it in your piping bag. Doing this helps reduce the air bubbles in the cream when you are piping, so that it comes out more stable and neat. Yeah, yeah, I can see now you understand what I mean by that. So this is my cream, and I would like to use that and a bit of the white one. So we also do the same to the white one on the side. Now I get my piping bag and I get my cream here on one side. Mercy, tell us how the feeling is. So how is the cake, Mercy?
It's really nice. You can taste mm-hmm. the mangoes, mm-hmm. the flavor, mm-hmm. even the lemon.
Is it vanilla any longer?
No, you can't taste any vanilla in it.
What is the taste of the cake?
And lemon. Mm-hmm. You have a bit of lemon in the mm-hmm. mango.
And how is the cream?
It's sweet, but not too sweet. Mm-hmm. And it's
the feeling, and the feeling of the glaze within the cream.
Yes.
With that lemon taste in it from the glaze.
Yes.
Something. Yeah, yeah. It's so specific. Yes. Yes.